This lesson is about solving problems that contain percentages. You can also look at it as solving equations that contain percentages. To begin, we're going to very quickly define equation and percentages. An equation is an expression showing that two quantities are equal. Here's an example. 5 plus 2 equals 7. The equation is identified by the equal sign. Again, both expressions on both sides of the equal signs are equal. So this is a true statement. Now on to percent. A percent is pretty much just a part of 100. You can also know that a number is a percent because of the percent sign. Let's work one of the problems. Here's a word problem. What is 15% of 40? You may be asking yourself, we need a formula. Here you go. Percent over 100 equals is over of. First, we're going to plug what we know into this formula to show you how it works. 15%, of course, must go in the same spot where the 15% is over 100. So we have 15, which is a part of 100. Thus, we place the 15 over 100. Next, you see the parts that are flashing, the of 40. And for all you English majors out there, of is a preposition, so 40 must be the direct object of the preposition. Thus, we place 40 where of is in our formula. Let's move on to the next one. We have what is, and you see is right there on the formula, but we don't have a value to plug in. So is will be our unknown. And we're going to replace is with an x so that we know that's the value we're going to be looking for. Now let's move on to our next step. Here, since we've plugged in everything we know into our formula, we're going to begin to solve for the unknown. Okay, pay attention, because here's where a lot of people get lost. Multiplying equations are different from multiplying fractions. We're going to multiply diagonally. Look at the diagram here. And you can see we're going to start from 100 and we're going to multiply the x. Then we're going to come back and we're going to multiply the 40 and the 15. Here's how it looks. 15 times 40. We're going to insert our equal sign. 100 times x. See how that's different? Now we're going to simplify. 15 times 40 equals 600. Now this is the new equation that we're going to continue to keep simplifying, and we're going to work from here. Now that we have our new problem that we're going to work from, we have to get x by itself. And you may be asking yourself the question, well, how? What we're going to do is we have to first understand that this is an equation. It must stay balanced. When I say balanced, think of it as being on a scale. And as it teeter-totters here, what you do to one side of the equation, you're going to have to do to the other side. The terms must stay balanced. Again, what you do to one side, you must do to the other. You must keep both terms balanced. So what we're going to do to get x by itself is we're going to use a reverse operation. A reverse operation is just simply if you add, then you subtract to get the reverse, or to cancel out the first operation. If you multiply, you divide in order to cancel out the first operation. To make it make all sense to you, we're going to work the problem. To get x by itself, since 100 is multiplied into x, we divide 100 to reverse the operation and get x by itself. To keep the equation balanced, we must divide 100 by the other side as well. Now, you can see with the 100x, that should cancel out. So we have x by itself on that side of the equation. Now we have to continue and simplify 600 divided by 100, which divided simply gives us 6. So now we've got an x by itself, and we have our solution. 6 is the answer to our problem. What is 15% of 40? Now we check our answer. We all know that 6 now is 15% of 40. And what we do is we plug 6 back into our original problem. Here's how we do it. We understand that 15 over 100 was equal to x over 40. Now we know that x is 6. So now we again cross multiply or multiply diagonally across the equal sign to begin again to solve the equation to see if the equation stays balanced. Here we have 15 multiplied into 40, 6 multiplied into 100. 15 times 40 is 600, okay? And 6 times 100 is 600. So our solution works. The equation is balanced. That's the end of this video. Now you can look at the other three videos in this series to make sure you have a full understanding of how the formula I gave you works with the other word problems. Take care and thanks.